Oh, hey guys. I apologize for any sort of technical difficulties that happened today. I am using my new iPod Nano for my video this week. Let me know what you think of this new iPod setup. I have been exploring some podcasts and I found one that I've heard of quite a lot and haven't ever listened to much, but finally downloaded one of their podcasts through iTunes. And the group is called the Fab Fourum. I'm sure you guys probably have heard of them before. They're most likely, I don't know, they're my favorite Beatles podcast. I believe they also have it available for download at podarama.com. They are all radio people, radio broadcast people, the four of them. They are really, really funny, and they have some great things to say. I really enjoy listening to their podcast. They've got lots of good information. Also kind of mixed in with some humor, which is totally cool with me because I really love their sense of humor. They crack me up. They did a series of a couple of shows on Beatles on their favorite Beatles parodies, and I thought they brought some of the really, really good ones up. Which brings me to my next subject, which is the Rutles. They did an entire show talking about the Beatles parody, The Rutles. And, which was absolutely hysterical. I love hearing people quote the Rutles because I never hear it in normal, everyday life. I have to listen to the Fab Fourum to get my Rutles quotes. But, yeah, it was a great show. I really enjoyed it. That was my first show listening to them, and then I've since listened to their other podcasts about, the Beatles parody. So you guys should definitely give them a listen. I'll post a link in this thing, or whatever it is now. It was a sidebar and now it's a down below thing, and I don't even know. YouTube is just confusing the crud out of me lately. So, you know, I'll put it wherever and just look for it, you know, I'll throw it on the page somewhere and you can look for the links. But yeah, definitely give them a listen. They're very cool. I don't know if you guys have seen the Rutles or not. If you haven't, shame on you. You need to go out and find a copy of the Rutles. All you need is cash. Because that's their first movie. I don't like the second one very much. It was called Can't Buy Me Lunch. Not very good. But All You Need Is Cash was released in 1978. It's freaking hysterical. If you just need to go find a copy of it if you haven't watched it. Since a lot of you guys are, a lot of our audience for TheBeatleScruffs are people that are very, 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 very into the Beatles and know a lot of their history and a lot of things that a normal, you know, sort of casual fan would not know. So if you are one of these big Beatle fans and you haven't seen the movie yet, you really need to go find a copy. It's almost like a parody of the history of the Beatles, which was a parody itself. I don't know. I don't even know how to explain it. It's kind of confusing. The first movie, All You Need Is Cash, was basically a full look at the It kind of did like a chronological look at the Rutles' history, which are, you know, also known as the Prefab Four. The movie was actually scarily accurate as far as history goes. Of course, they parody everything in the history of the Beatles, but it was just, I watched the movie, I don't know, a couple months ago now. I didn't really know about it until fairly recently. It's probably in February or January I watched the movie finally. And it was hilarious. If you like Monty Python and you like the Beatles, watch the Rutles. Hilarious. It do just absolutely impeccable parodies of these songs and the albums and the movies, and it's just so funny. But the four characters are Ron Nasty, Dirk McQuickley, Stig O'Hara, and Barrington Womble, who became Barry Wom, who is the Ringo Starr character, and he's really funny. But yeah, those are the four guys and all of their relationships and all of the stupid things that they said over the years. The real Beatles, all of the dumb things that they've said over the years and all of their relationships and all of their albums and their songs are parodied in this movie. And for example, you know, in their names, obviously, you can hear that Dirk McQuickley is obviously Paul McCartney, and Stig O'Hara, George Harrison, definitely. But they parody a lot of the songs. When they wrote the songs, Eric Idle was very involved in the writing of all of the songs in the movie. And so he and George Harrison were really good friends. And George Harrison was actually in on the movie. He's an interviewer in the movie outside of Rutlecore, which is supposed to parody Applecore. If you've watched the Beatles anthology, you can definitely see that the Beatles also thought that Applecore was kind of a joke to some extent. The Apple Boutique, people kind of just came in and took whatever they want. And so George Harrison is standing outside of Rutlecore interviewing sort of the Rutles manager of Apple figure, and which is Michael Palin, who is a python. If you know the Lumberjack sketch, you'll know who Michael Palin is. Leaping from tree to tree. George Harrison is standing outside and he's interviewing, and while he's interviewing him about things being taken out of the Rutlecore boutique and just, you know, out of the offices, people are walking out behind and just taking things and all of this stuff, and it's just hysterical the way that they do it. But Eric Idle, to me, is one of the greater comic geniuses of our time, so definitely give it a watch. I'll post some links, like I said, to maybe some clips and where you can find the movie. Okay, so that's it for this week. Hope you enjoyed the little bit of tomfoolery about the Rutles and the Fab Fourum. Like I said, check out those links, and yeah, we'll see you guys next week. Have a great week. See you on Saturday. Bye!